Hello, folks. Welcome to today's stream. This stream is sponsored by Microsoft Azure. You know, it's not going to be 100% pure Azure content, but it'll be very much focused on getting this deployed onto Azure. Let's go create a list of to-dos here. So deploying onto Azure. So deploy the app itself, provision. I don't need Postgres, but that would make things easier. And then basically automate deployment. CLI. Those are my major goals, and then sort of secondary are alternate ways of deployment. So there's all sorts of plugins and SDKs and things like that for deployment. We're really starting from scratch here. Let's actually create a branch. Even though I generally don't like to create branches, this is a special case. So let's create a new branch. We're going to call it Azure. So we're on that branch. Let's get this to compile in 11. I don't think it's going to be too bad because I think most of the problems are small. I've got a few pattern matching places. That's records, pattern matching. All right, so let's fix the text blocks. So what do we want? We want that. I'm really bummed that there's not a, that IntelliJ is not asking me to convert this. Let's see, copy string literal into clipboard. Oh, let's do that. Okay, and then what I can do is have this and then paste it in. Okay, so that's fixed. Let's go rebuild and see what else is broken. So let's fix the pattern matching. That wasn't quite what I thought it would do. Let's cast. Let's take this out, and now we'll have to cast this. Create a local variable. This should be OAuth to user. It's actually that, and that's auth get principal. No, not get authorities, get principal. Come on, there we go, and cast it. Insert that, and then we can grab this, do that, and that. I wanted to convert to a class. Let's rebuild, see where we're at. Wait, seriously? That was it? We fixed it all? So everything built. Now the key is let's run all our tests. So we're going to run all the tests. Okay, so everything works. Let's run the application just to be sure the application works. Sign in. Okay, so that's working. Okay, so everything's working fine. That was the fun part. All right, to complete this quick start, JDK 11. All right, we're there now. Sign up for Azure subscription. I got one. Install the Azure toolkit for IntelliJ. I think I did that. So let's go sign in. I don't know what it's going to do, so I'm going to go and switch to my secret window. So hold on. So it was interesting. It actually popped up a browser that had four options. One was consume the CLI's authentication, and then there were a couple others about device stuff. So it actually worked with consuming the CLI authentication, which was pretty cool. So did that. I don't want to create a new one. Azure Spring Cloud is a service, so I need to create that. That's a subscription I'll use. I'm just going to create a new one. This will be... call this MobReg. This is the name of the service, which I guess I'll also call MobReg. May as well make it central. Why not? Pricing. I don't... is there a cheaper tier? No, that's the cheapest tier. Charge per second. Oh, let's turn on the Java in-process agent. Sampling rate. That seems fine. That's all fine. I'd like to create. Now I can create. All right, so the service is created. I think the service, though, is available enough that I can go. Should I connect to the resource? Let's connect to the resource. No, not SQL server. Deploy to Azure Cloud. Hey, look, MobReg service. App, that's my app name. Ooh, more settings. Seems to me this should not be under more settings. So Java 11. So build and deploy, deploy. Oh, here it goes. Well, that's interesting. So it's documenting this here for how to deploy to Spring Cloud. So this is public endpoint, which I assume I want. And then persistent storage, I don't think I want that. So artifact, so I guess this is the creating the app part. So set public endpoint to enable, selecting instance cloud, did that already. Say create app. I actually didn't have to do create app. And I guess it's then start the deployment. So let's go run and we'll maximize this. Oh, right, it's going to run all the tests. So this is most certainly going to fail when it deploys because there's no database. Deployment is complete. Oh, let's actually go back and see what happened. There are test failures. There should not be any test failures. All right, and let's go disable those tests. Disabled. And then the other one is the mob timer, such sender tests. We'll disable that one. All right, so I guess we've got to try that deploy again. Okay, so we were going to create a database. Then let's create a database. Yeah, we would like single server. Version 11. I hope that's not a problem because I'm using PostgreSQL 13. We're going to put this under the MobReg resource group. Server name, MobReg. Server admin login name. Should I just do admin and password? Let's review and create. So let's go back home. Let's go back to IntelliJ because it was deploying. Started updating deployment. It says created successfully. And looks like it threw an exception. Great. Let me go delete. So it looks like I'm going to be creating a new app. Let me go delete the other one. So Spring Cloud app. Let's go delete you. I'm going to go, let's see, create the app with the public endpoint assigned. If you need, if you selected Java version 11 when generating, include the runtime. Ah, so this is something it failed to do. Let's take that. And then we'll do that. And we'll add a space. What's my resource group name? I think it's MobReg. Yes, MobReg. Does case matter? Let's assume it does. A service instance name, MobReg service. Name of the app. So I think that's everything I need. This command requires the extension Spring Cloud. I think it may have mentioned I was supposed to install that in some other place. All right, so that's creating the app. Basically, I want to get it to the point where it's deployed and running, at least starts, and then I want to see the failure logs because it can't connect to the database. So let's go ahead and take a look at here. This is our local PostgreSQL properties. In fact, let's go back to our list of what we're doing. This is done. We provisioned it. And so as part of that, we need to set the JDBC URL, basic data source info, URL, username, password, so PostgreSQL. So we did the provision database, invars for GitHub OAuth. So we need basically the client ID, client secret, specifically that. GitHub personal access token. All right, got our migration. So that's all good for PostgreSQL. So let's copy this over and we'll basically call it Azure. So I'll need to set the profile to be Azure. So it's going to grab these properties for the GitHub client ID and client secret, and then we'll need the database ones for that. So let's put here, this is Azure, and then this, the URL, which is basically that. So that's the admin username, as we'll grab that. And the database password, I don't really care if anybody sees it because you can't get to the database. So it's not demo, it's MobReg. That's fine. And that's fine. We can deploy again. Let's go do that. So what was the deploy sequence? All right. And now artifact, deploy MobReg, 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 artifact, artifact. Okay. There we go. And let's see what happens. Well, it looks like it's successfully connected because it successfully validated two migrations and migrated the database. So I guess it's up. Now I will need to figure out how to do the environment variables. So let's take a look. All right, we'll sign in. This is good. This is exactly what I would have expected. I need to now authorize MobReg running on Azure. So we will authorize. I like how I'm Ted Young and I'm authorizing Ted Young. All right. We're logged in and I should be able to go to the admin dashboard. It's all working. So let's go create a huddle. And there it is. And then if I go back and look at it as the member point of view, then there it is. We have a successful deployment and operation of the application. Very nice. Let's go back to the app. So there's all our traffic, our 20 requests. Curious if there's much to the application map, because it's not really... Well, there we go. Well, that's cool. It made 310 calls to the SQL database. I can view the details. That's cool. It made 10 calls to API, github.com. Yeah, so this application insights is really, really cool. All right. Thanks, everyone. I appreciate you hanging out, going along for the ride. And so have a great rest of your day, and I will see you next time.